Meanwhile, Thailand downgraded its economic growth forecast for this year as it battles its worst COVID-19 wave, which has brought record numbers of new infections and deaths. The kingdom last year suffered its worst full-year performance since the Asian financial crisis of 1997 with a 6.1% economic contraction. The Office of the National Economic and Social Development Council, or NESDC, had initially given a cool forecast for recovery during the first quarter, estimating growth of 1.5 to 2.5% for this year. But on Monday, NESDC Secretary General Danucha Pichayanan announced it had to revise that figure down to between 0.7 and 1.2%. He said, quote, "This crisis caused by the pandemic is unlike the financial crisis of 1997 and 2009. Our estimation is based on domestic causes." Thailand's GDP for the second quarter was up 7.5% on the same period last year, the first sign of recovery since the pandemic. The growth was most visible in agricultural, industrial, and export sectors, while tourism, once Thailand's cash cow, remained sluggish. The kingdom has gradually reopened borders to vaccinated travelers via a quarantine-free program in ultra-popular beach island of Phuket, drawing more than 34,700 tourists to its sun-soaked shores since the so-called sandbox launched on July 1. But COVID-19 cases there have also started to climb. Restrictions were enacted last month on Phuket's businesses, shuttering pubs, boxing studios, and karaoke lounges, while domestic travelers have been barred from entering the island. Authorities said over the weekend, the restrictions on entertainment venues in Phuket would continue for another 2 weeks. Since the start of the pandemic, Thailand has recorded 928,314 cases with 7,733 deaths, the bulk of them detected since April.